Hello all,
my name is Harish. I'm one of the PMs on the marketplace team, and I'm here to talk about a functionality that we are planning to release over the next few weeks, in the next couple of weeks. So this functionality is called App Features, and there's also another small component to it called App Feature Compatibility. So let me walk you through what the functionality is about. And before I go into the actual functionality, I definitely wanted to talk about why we are doing that in the first place. We have more than 1,400 apps in the app marketplace, and all of them have multiple features. They have the main feature, and then they do a lot of other things as well. A customer comes into the app marketplace, and I'm just going to select Zapier as an example here. They click on Zapier. They see, hey, I want to have some certain things figured out. So what can I do with Zapier? And it says, hey, I can create or update HubSpot contacts from new Google contacts. I can log new Intercam users in HubSpot. Oh, this actually helps me solve my problem. I'm going to install it. And they install that. But after that, they lose context on the setup guide because either they have to go into the app and search for the setup instructions, where in some apps it's very clear, in other apps it's hard to navigate from one section to another, or basically find the flow on how can I implement these particular apps? Like exactly how can I create or update a HubSpot contact from a new Google contact? What is the steps is that? Is it the single step where I hit a connect button somewhere and then everything is automatic? Or they have to go and set up like a workflow from scratch with mentioning each step. Is it like a 5-step thing? We don't know. Like that, they lose the context with that. And what happens in the end is that the customers get disillusioned with the app and then they uninstall the app. We have a stat where we've seen like more than 50% of the people actually uninstall an app within the first 30 days because they are not able to implement or set up the features that they actually install the app for. So, for that, we started doing a new feature, and let me go back to the main home there. So this is my developer portal, and I'm going to walk you through the new app features, our app feature editor that we have brought up. So to get to that, you need to go to your developer account, go to marketplace, click on app listings. I only have one listing, but if you have multiple listings, select the app listing that you think you need. You're planning on adding the app features for, click on it. And then just a quick call out, it'll lead you to the app partner dashboard. If you haven't looked at the app partner dashboard, I highly recommend you to look at the app partner dashboard. It has a lot of different metrics. Obviously mine is empty because mine is in a dev network, but you will be able to get a lot of insights about how your marketplace listing is doing. You'll also get insights about how your customer feedback is, your ratings, reviews, uninstall responses, the private feedback, which is left at the end of a review. Everything in one place. And you can also leave any partner feedback in this feedback, share your feedback survey. This is something that is monitored by us. We'll take a look at it and get back to you with that. Now, getting back to the app listing again. Here, you come in here and you click on the edit listing. So it'll take you to your app listing flow. This is your existing app listing flow. However, you'll notice that we add a new feature, a new section called app features here. What is an app feature here? It's essentially a functionality that the app performs. And let me go into an app feature. So typically, I have some existing features that I created mainly to show you what the flow is. But if you are a new app, you can click on add a feature and it'll take you to the same flow. So I'm just opening one of the ones which I had recently created. The feature name is very similar to what you do for your app marketplace. So very similar to the same name there. And the description is also very similar to exact description, more customer facing. How will this add value to the user and what problem does it solve and all that stuff. Now coming to scope groups, we will be using these scope groups to determine if this feature will work for a current HubSpot customer with their current plan. For example, we already have this functionality for the data sync apps, HubSpot data sync apps, but we are now opening it up to all apps. Let's say this feature uses the CRM object scope, the settings that user scope, CRM domain scope, it uses all these scopes. Now we'll take that into consideration. And when an in-app customer comes in and looks at the listing, they will have an indication on whether that feature will be compatible with their current plan or if they have to upgrade to move to the plan. In this case, both are compatible, but if it was not compatible, then you would have a message here with a red mark that says, hey, this feature is not compatible in the current plan. You will need to upgrade to Marketing Hub Pro to actually use this feature. That is the main goal of the scope groups. You should have all the scopes that you use set up in the app settings builder. Any scope that you have selected there is what you can see in this dropdown. We populated right from what you have selected in the app settings builder, all the scopes that you used. And then you can select the subset or what scopes that you've actually used in this feature in this scope groups box. If you have not set it on the app settings builder, that's why we have a link here. Click on it, go to your app settings page, select all the scopes that you use for the whole app. And then when you save it and when you come back here, it'll populate all the values here. If you haven't set up in the app settings builder, this dropdown will be blank. You have to set it up in the app settings builder before and save it before you come here. As I mentioned, description is very similar, existing, like how it looks in the app marketplace currently. So it's more, the description is more for customers to understand the value, what the feature is, what value does it provide, and customer facing thing. You have an option, you need to add an image generally. There is like an image tied to that feature. And here's the place where do you want to display this feature. So you can display it in the app marketplace listing, which is exactly here in the integration feature section. Or you can list it as a feature discovery card. The feature discovery cards are shown in the connected apps page. Now, how do I go to the connected apps page? This is one of my personal portals as well. So I'm here, I'm clicking on the marketplace, and you will see, if you have apps installed in your portal, you will see the connected apps pop up automatically. So when you click on connected apps, it takes you to this page where you see all the apps that you have installed. And when you click on an app, there is a section called feature discovery. And this has all the feature discovery cards in it. And that's what this basically means. Display is where you want to display the feature, the feature discovery card. So if you have selected this, it will display in this location as a card under this tab in the connected apps page. Now, looking at the previews on both the sides, right? As I mentioned, the preview will actually directly highlight any changes that have made will show up here. You can immediately see how the card will look. What is the final output of the card, whether it's in the marketplace or the feature discovery. The main difference between the two previews are the two buttons there below. The name is the same. The description is the same. We have kept it intentionally like that because we want the customers to make a connection on, hey, I installed this app for, like in the example of Zapier, I want to install this app to log new intercom users in HubSpot. I'm coming to the connected apps page. I see the log new intercom users to HubSpot. And then I click on learn more to understand how I can set up that particular feature. So to make this connection, we have kept it like a one-to-one, hey, a marketplace feature, a feature card kind of needs to be, it doesn't have to be always linked to a marketplace feature, but it makes more sense if all the marketplace features have a corresponding feature discovery card, mainly to help the customer set up that particular feature. So going into the feature discovery card flow here, the primary button, which is this one, there are three options that you can do. One is link to a feature. So you can already link to the existing HubSpot, different product areas in the HubSpot where you want to direct the user to. Two, you can create a custom link. So instead of go to deals, you can say go to a particular, go to CRM cards, and you can add like a particular dynamic link where you can either direct the user to a point in the portal, in their portal, or you can link them to your app where you can say, hey, sync with Zapier. And you can direct them with the link, which will take you to Zapier when they click on it, to a particular location where they exactly have to be for implementing that setup. Again, we would like these to be very focused on each feature that they're trying to do so that, and not be generic setup steps or anything like that sort. So this is the button for that. Or you can also have an option of no primary card button. So certain features are more of like you just want to walk the customer through the setup, but there's not actual action that they need to take or anything of that sort, then you can do that as well. And then for the how-to guide, which is this learn more button, I'm just going to go back and select this just for my case. You have three options. One, you can create a guide from scratch. So this is where it is. So you have a guide step one, guide step two. This is how it basically looks, where you have a title and then you can add a video or an image. And then you have step one, step two, you can be text-based. As of now, you have to add either an image or a video. Mainly, it is to help the users quickly understand based on the image or video on what it is. You can also do a video-only guide, which I'll show you closely. But essentially, you can create a setup guide with how many steps that you want, however, depending upon the complexity of the feature. I will quickly show you how it is if it's just a video guide. So this is an example where it's just a video guide. They can still do that. We got a feedback from app partners and from customers in general that they are more conducive to video consuming video content rather than reading like a longer text, especially if it is a complicated one. Whereas if in a video, if you walk through the steps clearly, they try to follow it much easier in that format though. So that's one of the reasons why we added like a video only guide as well, if you want that. Again, in the video only format, you cannot add any content or text in it. So if you want to add a video and text, I would say you can go to the create guide from scratch and that's sort of separate. So I'm going to go back, save, close. So now you can have, as I mentioned, a feature card, a feature being as a feature card. So in this case, let me save and close it. So I can have, so if you see the feature one is displayed in the marketplace and in the, as a feature discovery card in the Connect Apps page. Feature two is just seen in the Connect Apps page. The reason why we did it is because there may be some additional features which you didn't want to show in the marketplace app listing because there is a limit of 5 features that you can show in the listing. You cannot show more than 5 features in the listing, but there are a limit in the feature discovery cards is 10. So you can have up to 10 feature discovery cards in this one. So right now I have 2 feature discovery cards, 1 marketplace listing feature. So it's mainly to give the app partners more bandwidth on what they want to display in the Connect Apps page and how granular they want to go into the features and break it down and do all the stuff to give them that freedom with that. As I mentioned, any other questions or concerns, like please feel free to reach out to your app partners or reach out like one of the other, as I mentioned, let me just exit in quickly back to the dashboard here. We do have a survey. It's a survey, but it's essentially like a format with which we collect feedback as well. Hope you find this useful. And if you have any feedback, if you run into, we will be adding a separate KB article that will walk you through all these steps on how you create them as well. And all the feedback is welcome. Any feedback, like if you have a specific use case which is not met in this one, feel free to reach out to me or reach out to your app partners or go through the feedback survey that I mentioned, the key resources in the app partner dashboard for quick response. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Bye-bye.